Check it out. Charlie, if you heard it here first in my beer for tonight, back again with NFL Week 2 predictions. Courtesy of Market of Choice, Level Beer, Hazing is socially unacceptable. A New England style IPA coming in at 7.1%. And as you guys all know, during a prediction show, there's going to be a chug. So this is what I'm chugging tonight. So with that being said, let's get this going. You know what I'm saying? Here we go. I'm going to go backwards hat. And this week, I'm going to wear my good luck glasses. Good luck. Every time I wear these glasses, the Bears win games. The reason why the Bears haven't won many games is because I've misplaced these joints. So with that being said, predicting all winners this week, or better than last week. But here we go. Let's do this. So last week, I think I went 4-12, picking the Steelers to win, picking the Eagles to win, picking the Panthers to win, and the Rams. And the rest of the game, I just basically shit the bed. I didn't know what the hell was going on. So this week, Thursday night football, we got my man Deshaun Watson will get the start. Andy Dalton will get the start. I guess you can say he'll get a do-over because he stunk up the joint last week. It's a short week for these players. So both teams. So I guess what I'm saying, I'm taking the Texans defense to spook Dalton like the Ravens spooked him. And I'm going to go ahead and say the Texans win this game 21-16. Ravens will start 2-0 because they're playing the Browns. And like I said, if you're playing the Browns, you don't necessarily have to prepare, but you will prepare just to prepare to find a way to really beat them down. So I'm going with the Ravens to beat the Browns, just like the Steelers beat the Browns, a score of 24-16 Ravens. My Chicago Bears. Boom, my Chicago Bears. They played pretty decent against the Falcons last Sunday. The Bears have a winning record against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. They won the last 3 out of 4. They did get beat down last season. I believe the score was 36-10. I feel the Bears will bounce back. So, with that being said, I'm taking my Chicago Bears to win 25-18. The Patriots bounce back. The team I picked to win the AFC to, you know, represent the AFC in the Super Bowl. So, I'm going to take the Patriots over the Saints 31-24. Yeah, 31-24. Brandon Cooks will have a monster game. He's on my fantasy team. Tom Brady is on my fantasy team. So we win it. Boom. Eagles, Chiefs. Huh, my man, Sean, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to do this. You know, I'm not sorry because I'm not going to take the Chiefs over the Eagles. I'm rolling with the Eagles. I think it's an interesting matchup. And I'm taking the Eagles because I think their defense. I'm taking the Eagles because I think their defense will come out. They're going to come out after Alex Smith. They're not going to come out flat like the Patriots came out flat against the Chiefs. So, boom. I'm taking the Eagles to win that game 26-21. We got the Titans will take care of business this week against the Jags. I think that was a fluky game, the Jags playing the Texans. I picked the Texans to win that game. As you guys know, I'm a big Texans fan this year based on episode 10 of, You Heard It Here First. So I'm rolling with the Titans to take care of business against the Jags. 21-20 will be an extremely close game. I mean, it's a division matchup. It wasn't really a close game against Texans versus the Jags, and that's a division matchup, but I think this will be a close game because both these teams have been at the bottom of that division the last couple of years, so it'll be interesting to see these two teams battle it out. Colts will drop another game. I mean, who's surprised at that? They're going to lose. Cardinals going to take care of business 26-18. The jury is still out on the Panthers. I mean, they played the 49ers week one. Everyone can beat them. I think I can get myself and 10 of my friends, and we can go out there in pads and beat the 49ers. So nothing to worry about them. But the Panthers will take care of business against the Buffalo Bills 24-17. I picked up the Raiders defense for fantasy this week. I made some changes to my team. Dropped some people. I picked the Raiders up only because they're playing the Jets. I know the Raiders defense isn't nothing to write home about, but I think they'll do enough to get the win and score big points against the Jets. So, score 28-14 Raiders. I'm taking the Raiders over the Jets. Jay Cutler versus Phillip Rivers. That's a nice matchup. It's only because these guys have hated each other since they both were quarterbacking in the AFC West. Jay Cutler was with the Broncos, Phillip Rivers with the Chargers, not a Los Angeles Chargers. This is an interesting game, you know what I'm saying? Based on these two guys, they both whine and cry and they like to talk trash to each other. And I'm talking about on the field trash talking. It's kind of crazy. If you're a big fan of the AFC West, you know about these two gentlemen going back and forth with each other. So, man, Chargers should have won on Monday night against the Broncos. I picked the Chargers to win that game. They didn't. I don't know, man. I'm almost positive that they will get the win this Sunday against the Dolphins, 26-21. I think Cutler will go out there and make some plays and, you know what I'm saying, you know, show that he still can play, but people will still hate the guy. I'm a big Jay Cutler fan. Whatever, you can hate me, you can think I'm silly. I'm a big Jay Cutler fan, but he will not go out and get the job done. And the crazy thing is, they've had enough time to prepare. And even though I think they've had more than enough time to prepare, I just don't think they're going to get the job done. Phillip Rivers is going to get a win, and the Dolphins will take that L. Beatdown special, my beatdown special this week. The beatdown special is going to be the Seahawks smashing the 49ers. Another division rivalry. Now, a few years ago, 3-4 years ago, watching these two teams play was awesome. But in the last 2 years, it's just been a snooze fest. It's been extremely boring. So I'm going to take the Seahawks 28-13. Now, I know you're saying that's not necessarily a beatdown. I guess what I'm saying is the Seahawks are going to go out there. They're going to beat them down, but they're going to also find a way to let the 49ers, and I don't mean let, but give up a few points, because, they gave up more points than I thought they were going to give up against the Packers. So Seahawks 28-13 over the 49ers. I think the Packers get revenge from that NFC championship game where they got smacked by the Falcons. Crazy thing, my lady had just asked me, who should I start, Ben Roethlisberger or Matty Ice? And I told her it's a toss-up, but it's going to be a shootout, and I'm not sure who she should start. But one thing I am sure about, I'm positive that the Packers will win this game on the road. So I'm taking the Packers, and I think this is going to be the highest scoring game this week, but I'm taking the Packers to beat the Falcons 28-25. Combined score is going to be high, but it's going to be a close game. Another close game, just like I thought the Seahawks would win a close game against the Packers, and it was close and relatively for the score, but it was also a slow game that was pretty boring if you ask me. Man, Zeke versus the Broncos defense. I'm going to roll with the Broncos defense, so I'm going to take the Broncos and win that game 28-18. Steelers are at home against the Vikings. That's a tricky game. I don't know what to expect, because no one thought Sam Bradford would come out there and ball out like he did on Monday night on the big stage, and he did. He looked just like that Sam Bradford you wanted to see when he left Oklahoma University. So that was a big game, but I have Martavis Bryant on my fantasy team, so I'm taking Martavis Bryant. I'm taking Antonio Brown, Le'Veon Bell, and my man Big Ben Roethlisberger, the big fours, or the quadruple fours, or whatever the hell you want to call it. I'm rolling with the Steelers to win that game against the Vikings 25-19, and the Lions, they will go 2-0. Hometown, baby, rolling with the D. I don't hate them, I just don't rock with them like I rock with the Bears. Lions will win the game against the New York Giants in a score of 21-17. And the Washington football will drop another game. This is about to be the second time in a long time, or probably the second. I can't recall when I picked the Rams to win a game, but second time in a row. I picked them to win last week, they won. I'm picking them to win this week, and they're gonna beat the Washington football team, a score of 23-21. That's it. Lucky glasses are off. Sun is going down. Drink time. It's a long one tonight. Long-winded. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. This is pouring up nice. There we go. Yes. Well, like I said, I got the Level Hazy IPA. Booyah. Fancy glass. Cheers. Y'all be easy. Enjoy your football weekend. College, pro, whatever that may be. Cheers. I'm Charlie, if you heard it here first, and I'm out.